In this video, I'm going to show you a very simple way to get rid of blue-green algae that not a lot of people are talking about, actually. Hey guys, welcome to another algae guide video. I believe this is episode 4. I was thinking today, like, how many episodes are we going to have, actually? How many different types of algae are there? Well, I think we're about halfway now, so the algae guide is almost finished. So this episode is about blue-green algae, also known as cyanobacteria. So technically it's not even an algae, but who cares, it looks like algae, so let's just call it that way. Alright, first things first, if you're not sure whether or not you have blue-green algae, there's one very simple trick to identify it, and that's just smelling the algae. So normal algae doesn't really have a particular smell, but cyanobacteria, it doesn't smell too good. I would describe the smell as swamp. I don't think I've ever been into a swamp, but yeah, whenever I smell blue-green algae, that's the first word that comes to my mind. Besides the smell, this algae has another very lovely characteristic, and that is the fact that it's able to photosynthesize. So this algae can grow in the same way as plants grow, by using light as a food source. And that's why a lot of times when you read up about blue-green algae, the first thing you'll notice is that the people suggest a blackout. We'll talk more about that later. So in my opinion, there are three main triggers that will cause a blue-green algae. So let's go over these one by one. First one has everything to do with your substrate. So a lot of times you will start noticing blue-green algae on top of your sand and your substrate. And if you have a substrate layer that is very compact, that does not have a lot of air pockets and does not get a lot of fresh water, then that's a very nice place for blue-green algae to settle. The second trigger is low nitrates, and this actually happens to me quite often. So especially with aquascaping, you know, we just love red plants, and we can make those red plants even more vividly red by reducing the nitrates, so we limit the nitrogen supply that we fertilize. At the same time, aquasol is also absorbing nitrate, so whenever I do a water test for nitrate, the values are usually quite low. And I always notice that when I haven't dosed any nitrogen in a little while, I start seeing some blue-green algae pop up here and there. And that's basically when I know I've gone too far. And the third trigger for blue-green algae is high phosphates. This again has everything to do with your maintenance routine. If you're not doing regular water changes and you have a lot of waste organics building up, you're gonna have high phosphates, and that will also trigger blue-green algae. Okay, so how are we gonna get rid of the blue-green algae? First of all, fish, shrimp, snails, they're not gonna touch it. It's disgusting, they will not eat it. So we're gonna have to do the hard work ourselves. Okay, so when people are struggling with blue-green algae, the first advice people will give them is to do a blackout treatment. I'm not saying that that's bad advice, but it's quite a harsh treatment, and it's a lot of work. You have to cover your entire aquarium with blankets, with plastic bags, something like that, and then you have to look at that ugly mess for 4 or 5 days. I'm pretty sure it works, because this algae needs light to grow, so if you starve it from light, it will have some effect. But I think there's easier ways to get rid of it. So what I would like you to do next time you have some issues with blue-green algae is to start either dosing a nitrogen fertilizer or increase your dosage. And keep this at about 30 parts per million. You can be quite excessive with nitrogen fertilizers. I mean, they're not really harmful. You can't really overdose it too much. So keep it at about 30 parts per million for about 2 weeks. And I'm pretty sure that after 2 weeks, you should definitely start seeing some results. As I mentioned earlier, if you have this dense substrate that does not allow for a lot of oxygen, then you're probably gonna have some blue-green algae. In that case, you can remove most of it by using a gravel vacuum. I think that works quite well, but again, it only works for a small group of people. If you have a densely planted tank, it's probably not gonna work for you. And if you have a nutrient-rich layer underneath your substrate, using a gravel vacuum is also gonna mess it up. So this one is only for a select few people. Now my next solution is using antibiotics. I've personally never tried this, but it does make a lot of sense, since this algae is actually a bacteria. So using antibiotics. I saw this in a video from Aquarium Co-op. where they use a product called erythromycin, if I say that correctly, product from API. I'll leave a link in the description box below. But yeah, this is some sort of antibiotics for fish disease, and apparently this works very well to combat blue-green algae. So that's another suggestion. So if those three things do not work for you, then I would suggest you to do a blackout treatment. Just make sure it really is pitch black, because like one small light beam and this is not going to work, and it's those 4 or 5 days have been a waste. And also make sure that you provide enough oxygen for your fish, so either during those 4 or 5 days run an air pump or elevate your filter outflow so you provide enough oxygen for your fish. Now, to make sure this algae does not come back, a few things we can do. Number one, we can keep our phosphate levels low. So just do our regular maintenance, do our water changes, make sure there's no waste organics building up somewhere. Keep your nitrate levels decent. I would say 20 milligrams per liter is good. And last thing we can do is keep our temperature low as well. So blue-green algae just loves high temperature, loves warm water. I always get a little bit of blue-green algae in the summer usually. And yeah, that's it. I think that's everything I have on blue-green algae. So I hope this video will help you get rid of your issues with this algae. Stay tuned for next week's video. It's probably going to be green spot or green dust algae. Haven't decided yet. If this video was helpful, give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't done it already. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care. Bye.